matchups and unpredictable fighters where it's not preset that you know who's going to be winning, who's going to be losing. So that's what we're trying to create here. It's exciting matchups that guys going to bang in the ring and give a show for everybody.
And when you want to talk about exciting fighters, Stranya Gavrilovic, one of those types of fighters, he comes in with a menacing look on his face. He can take a lot of punishment and he can dish it out. This guy is a real showman.
Absolutely, I'm very excited to have him on our show. And today I think he's gonna prove to everybody what he's really made, because now he's four fights pro MMA against somebody that has a little bit more experience with over 14 fights and fought in Europe. So I think that's a good challenge for Stranya Gavrilovic tonight.
Yeah, and it's interesting because, you know, a lot of the feeling with people is that maybe Roaming is more skilled, more slick, more talented, but Stranya is a heart guy, he's a game day guy, he's a mentally strong guy, and sometimes those guys just find ways to win.
Absolutely, they, you know, he comes from a part not far from where we come from, you know, he's and he reminds of us, you know. It's very like, he goes there with his heart, and that's what we want to see tonight. Somebody that's going to give his heart in the ring of Fight for Pride, and I think the best will win tonight against him.
But Johann Roaming did not fly all the way from France to lose tonight. He is here to put on a show and steal the thunder away from Stranya Gavrilovic.
Yeah, I love the matchup. And again, you know, I want to commend you guys. Especially when shows are developing, a lot of times you'll see local guy versus some guy not as good as him. They win really quickly and easily. The crowd cheers a bit, and then the night is over. And that's not a way to build a show. And you've built a show all night long, top to bottom. These matchups are tough for both guys.
Absolutely. You know, I'm a promoter right now, and I act as a promoter, even though I've been doing mixed martial arts for over 25 years. And my goal is to not have guys easy wins and not
the
promote
world.
Specific teams. So everybody's equal for me right now.
Gavrilovic.
Oh, we hear the crowd cheering.
You hear the crowd. That means Stranya Gavrilovic will be ready to go. And he would love to do nothing more than steal a victory away from Gavrilovic
tonight.
Yeah,
wreck the party for everybody here. And it's exactly the way you want to approach a guy like this. Wow, listen to the crowd, eh? This is how you want to approach a guy like this. You can't fight fire with fire. But man, he's calm and he's collected in the ring, but Stranya is going to be the opposite.
Another funny thing is that a lot of guys come in with pump music, you know, and he comes in with something that we would come into, you know, with something that inspires us deeply, not just by banging and club partying, you know, so.
Yeah, it is interesting. Every fighter is different. A guy like Stranya is so wound up and so, you know, aggressive that if you put some heavy metal song or some banging club tune on here, it might set him over the top. This reels him in, seems to center him a little bit, and it'll calm him now, and he'll be wound up in the important time. It's not important to be wound up walking down here in front of all these people. It's important to be wound up and ready when you're standing in here with another professional athlete who's trying to hurt you.
Absolutely, like an animal. You calm him down before the feast, you know, so.
Listen to this audience, it's awesome.
Gavrilovic, a representative of Team Bergeron. However, Robin, the last time he has competed in professional mixed martial arts, it was in May of 2013.
Mesdames, messieurs, le prochain combat est prévu pour 3 rounds, 5 minutes. Dans la catégorie des poids moyens. Ladies and gentlemen, next bout is scheduled for 3 5-minute rounds in the middleweight division and is proudly brought to you by Montreal Limousines Worldwide. Les juges pour ce combat de judges for this bout. Guy Girard, Luc Lefebvre et David Thérien. L'arbitre, the third man inside the square, Yannick Louf. Présentant tout premièrement dans le coin bleu, introducing first in the blue corner. He officially weighed in at 184.7 pounds. Il enregistre un poids de 184.7 livres. His professional mixed martial arts record as follows. 9 wins with 6 wins coming by knockout or submission in 14 outings as a mixed martial arts professional. Representing BTTNCU de Paris, France, Johan R. Romy. Son adversaire dans le coin rouge, his opponent in the red corner. Official weight, a solid 185.5 pounds. S'affiche, parfait. Professional mixed martial arts record, absolutely perfect. 4 wins, no defeats, with 3 wins coming by way of knockout or submission. Il représente fièrement Team Bergeron. Ladies and gentlemen, mesdames, mesdemoiselles, messieurs, de Drummondville, Québec, the werewolf, Strahinja Gavrilovi.
Robin, I'm not sure. Who is the crowd cheering for in this fight?
I thought it was John Ramdin. I thought the crowd was cheering for John Ramdin.
3 5-minute rounds. The division, 185 pounds. Strahinja Gavrilovic in the green shorts. His adversary tonight, Johan Roming, in the red. This one's going to be fun.
Strahinja offered up the hand and said, let's glove touch. Roming nodded his head. It's all pleasant. It's very friendly right now, and it's about to become very violent.
And we are underway. The two fighters touch gloves. Gavrilovic controlling the center of the ring, but it is Roming who initiates the first attack.
John Ramdin and Robin Black here. We're pleased to be joined by Boris Sherbatov, one of the promoters. We'll probably ask him a couple more things as we get in here, but it's going to be just a real privilege to call this fight.
And Robin, you look at the two men. Oh. Look at that fancy kick by Roming. Gavrilovic definitely seems like the larger of the two.
Yeah, he definitely is. And he can take a shot.
And we've seen that this guy can take leg kicks.
Yeah. Roming is just starting to heat up here. I like the look of Roming, man. Just very relaxed. But you're right. Yeah, you can kick his leg a lot, but you'll probably hurt your leg, and it's not going to slow him down. But having said that, that's a test Roming would probably like to try.
And Robin, we've talked about it in the past. The pressure is on for Gavrilovic. We heard the crowd here. They came to see him perform. They came to see him put on a show.
Yeah.
And he has to deliver.
Yeah, he does. You saw that left, that jab, the level change jab. He might use it to set up the overhand right or shoot off of it. There's the overhand right.
Roming with his best Lyoto Machida impression there.
Great strategy here. Get in chest to chest. Join the hands. If you can lower the hands down the back, you'll be able to get this takedown. And the outside trip works.
And look at that. Roming looking to pass to side control. We'll have to be content with half guard.
Strahinja on his elbow. He's very nicely on his side with the underhook. This is a great place. He'll be able to get to his feet. Watch for knees here.
However, Roming... of his 9 victories, 5 have come by way of submission, a fact that Strahinja Gavrilovic is definitely aware of.
Yeah, Strahinja now knows that he can get up from under this man. That's a powerful knowledge to have in this fight now. Perfectly executed, the hip heist, get up with the underhook from the half guard position. If he can do that all night, he's not going to be as panicked about defending these takedowns, so he can open up some more offense.
How important is round one? How important is it that these fighters use it as a feeling out process?
Yeah, they're learning a lot about each other right now. And I like Roming's movement. He's showing different looks, minor feints, moving his head. That smile on his face is the perfect mental state for him in this fight. It's not a terrifying contest. It's a game he knows how to play.
Gavrilovic hoping to counter. Changing things up now. He continues to press forward. Roming targeting the head with that left kick.
Roming is by far the best fighter that we've seen Strahinja face. He's really skilled here. He's showing a lot of things. Level changes, different threats. He's very comfortable here. This is a badass matchup, man.
There you see that right kick targeted for the cranium of Johan Roming.
Watch for, yes.
And there you see Gavrilovic hoping to throw down. Roming once again pursuing the takedown.
Double underhooks for Roaming, so he's already deep in on a takedown. Strania trying to get his head underneath the chin. That will help. He wants to keep the elbows up high, bring him up high. He can't let that grip lower to the lower back, and he just accomplished that, did Roaming.
Gavrilovic forced to utilize energy.
He ain't no one-trick pony, though, either, man, because he's shown great takedown defense, get-ups. He's really evolved, this kid.
You see a small mouse forming under the right eye of the French fighter.
We're here with promoter Boris Sherbatov. Boris, is this what you were imagining when you put these two guys together?
Oh! Yeah, a great fight. Unpredictable things coming from both guys. Roaming stands for his 14 bouts in the ring. So we see his experience. Now it's up to Strania to bring his game up and to show what he can do.
Yeah, and that's the kind of test that you don't always see, especially with a local star like this, a guy who has an audience. That right hand just missed. Strania, we know how tough he is, how hard his head is.
And Roaming is starting to get very, very comfortable in there right now.
Yes, he is.
I shouldn't say starting, because he's looked comfortable since get-go.
Yeah, there's some men that are just bred for this. It's natural in them. Roaming is one of those men. He's in here against a very popular, very big, very explosive fighter here in Strania. And he's having a good time.
The crowd here in Laval, Quebec, loving all the action. Yep, Lovic. Getting some advice from his head coach, Yannick Bergeron, the leader of Team Bergeron.
I just love this audience standing up, all just drawn into the drama of what's happening here.
And Robin, if you're in the corner of Gavrilovic right now, what do you tell him? What does he need to be doing differently in round two?
Well, the good for him was all of the question marks. How's his takedown defense? If he does get taken down, how's his get-ups? All good. All of that is positive. We're good with that. But it's time for him to initiate a little more aggression. Use that natural pent-up aggression that he has. Use it wisely, but try to put some pressure, because you mentioned Roaming, how comfortable he is. We gotta make him uncomfortable if we're Strania Gavrilovic and his team.
Roaming's corner must be thrilled with the way round one transpired. As the two fighters touch gloves to signify the beginning of round number two. Some great action here at Fight for Pride Championship 2.
So far, Roaming can see everything Strania's throwing. He's had his best success when he's gone off level changes and feints. When he winds up a big shot, when he throws a kick, Roaming's so experienced, he's picking all that up. Roaming shows, flashes the thigh a little bit, shows the right kick, and then goes with the left, trying to keep Strania guessing, trying to tie his shoelaces together a little bit.
But there, and this is what people want to see.
That's exactly what we were talking about. Sometimes he's got to choose moments to use that aggression. Everything is working, he's managing the game well, but he's got to find pockets in which he can dish out some damage. And it's a risk because you can get taken down, but he's got to start taking these risks now.
Right there, a lunging right hand misses the mark.
Roaming is such an elegant fighter to watch. He flows nicely as he transfers his weight from hip to hip. He shows each shoulder movement. His hands move just enough to keep you guessing. That disguises when the punches are coming. He's an elegant fighter.
And he's having fun. You fought in your own backyard before. Talk about that pressure.
Yeah, you know, everybody in this, the great thing about all these people standing up and chanting your name is you feel the support.
Like right there, and this is what people came to see. Gavrilovic looks for the knockout, the uppercut. Roaming could be in trouble, thinks about that takedown, and the crowd on their feet here in Laval, Quebec.
And Strania Gavrilovic is doing exactly what we talked about. In moments, roll the dice a little and use your aggressive offense. That's what he's doing. As impressive as all of that was, possibly the most impressive was the way he defended the takedown in the middle of it.
You see the big grin on the face of Johan Roaming.
Johan Roaming feels alive right here, right now. He's feeling alive as he's dealing with this man and this giant army behind him, and he's putting on a good showing. This is a beautiful fight, man.
Is Gavrilovic evening things up here?
I think he is, but you see what Roming, he calmed himself down, and he went back to his jab, and now a couple of feints. So he's slowing this down. Beautiful
stuff. And a great
stuff.
Choice.
Yeah. Flashes the left hook and then goes to the body. Then he makes Strania have to second guess that left hand as he goes with a lead uppercut. So Strania's been fighting in bursts. That's a way to beat this guy, but you know, this guy is so stable and so calm and smart.
But now there, he's Gavrilovic trying to trap Roming in the corner. Oh. Roming senses it, tries to initiate the takedown, but escapes to the center of the ring.
Mr. Sherbatov, this is a nice matchup. Such different fighters, these two, but so well put together.
Thank you very
and
much.
There.
I love this. That's exactly what we want to see in the show.
Oh!
That's what we're bringing. That's amazing. Great, nice. So both guys are working hard. It's amazing.
Yeah, it really is. And they're so different. And, you know, you build a little recipe of how a fight will happen by just combining such interesting ingredients like this.
And we saw Gavrilovic trying to land that uppercut as Roming shot for the takedown. And there you see a huge breath taken by Johan Roming as he looks at his corner.
Every time Strania has him cornered, Strania can now anticipate a shot, a takedown.
Right
there,
there
it is. Because that feeling of being caged in, he's feeling caged in by that animal, and his reaction is that panicked shot. Strania's getting what he wants now. He's getting his way in this fight.
Now, do we anticipate that Gavrilovic will start targeting the body more often?
Oh!
But look at this! And that is it! Strania Gavrilovic gets the job done, and the crowd goes absolutely bananas!
Look behind you, brother. Look at these people going crazy. What a beautiful fight. And we see that Johan Roming is down. He took some big, big, big punches. Perfectly played by Gavrilovic. Managed the fight, did what he had to do to establish the takedown defense, and then lit him up in round two.
The crowd here at the Sport Expo, they want to burn this building to the ground.
Look at it as he just poured it on him. Such a fascinating fight. It unfolded so beautifully. You see, Roming wants to get up. He's a proud soldier, but, you know, they should keep him there, take care of him. He just was in an epic battle. You want to make sure that he's recovered.
And Robin, one of the reasons why this fight was so entertaining is because you have to have willing dance partners. You have to have guys that are willing to lay it all on the line for the victory. And we saw that from both men tonight.
Yes, sir, we did. And really, they both had the fight they wanted to have. That's the beautiful thing about it. Strania had to land violence, and he had to do it while defending those takedowns, while wearing out Roming with his weight and his size. He did exactly what he wanted. Roming is a beautifully talented fighter, and that was a wonderful thing to watch. I'm going to get a chance to talk to Strania Gavrilovic, but I definitely want to have a moment with Roming in the ring, too, because, you know, that man should be thanked for such a wonderful performance. Great, great fight. I'm going to leave you guys here at the table and go in and speak to the winner. I'm going to try to speak to both guys.
A great firefight at 185 pounds as we send it up to the ring announcer once again.
Mesdames, Mesdemoiselles, Messieurs, chronométrage officiel. 4 minutes, 11 secondes de la deuxième ronde. Ladies and gentlemen, the end comes dramatically. Official time, 4 minutes, 11 seconds of the second round. Your winner by knockout, the Will Strange Gavrilovic.
To 5-0 as a
professional. Ladies and gentlemen, please join me and thank Johan Roming for a beautiful, beautiful fight that he gave us tonight. Look at this guy.
How's it going?
Good, brother. How you doing?
Now, fine. Pretty fine. I trained hard for this fight. He tried to wrestle me. I trained my defense, and I show I can knock out. I can defense the takedown, and I'm glad to be close to you, man.
That was a wonderful thing you just laid out here for us. And that man that you fought there was an incredibly talented fighter. Incredibly talented fighter. And he came in here and he showed us a beautiful performance. You not only defended those takedowns, when you were on the bottom in half guard, you worked the underhook, you got out on one hip, you got to your feet. Who do you got to thank?
I have to thank Snowman, Rich. He showed me how to do underhooks, wrap the hand, and I do everything he showed me. You know, what I learned, I keep it in my head. And when I'm in the trouble, I try to use it.
And you used it tonight. What about this crowd? Did they help you?
Yeah, what?
This crowd, did they assist you in any way tonight?
Always. That's my fans. And I want to thank all of us because of us, the show is possible, you know?
Yeah.
No fans, no show, and I can't fight.
No, you're absolutely right. And listen, man, that was, like I said, that guy was very skilled. Yeah. And when you came out and you saw the way he was moving, he has an intimidating stand-up style. But you were relaxed, you got through round one, and you did exactly what you wanted to do. Who else do you got to thank, brother? Who else do you need to thank here?
My father and my mother, because they make me. That's, thank you. Thank you, Mom. Thank you, Dad.
Yeah, let's all thank his parents. Good job, Mr. Gavrilovic, knocking up the wife there. Ladies and gentlemen, your winner tonight, Stranja Gavrilovic.
A tremendous showing for both men. Stranja Gavrilovic, 5-0 as a professional. He is a star on the rise as we take a look. The action will continue momentarily here from Fight for Pride Championship 2. John Ramdean and Robin Black calling the action. And Robin, a tremendous showing from that 185-pound till. Johan Rahming and Stranja Gavrilovic delivering possibly fight of the night. But if anybody is going to top it is this 170-pound matchup between Chris Frank,
Martin,
the Hammer Grandma.
Yeah, this